Hey everybody, I'm Wohler's Wallet, and a few months back we heard rumors that the Citi Double Cash was getting an update and this would make it a possible game changer. So I actually decided to reach out to Citi, and sure enough, Citi confirmed it. So let's talk about this update and what does it mean for you. But first, if you're new to this channel is all about credit card rewards, and showing how to use your points and miles to travel for less. So if that's something that interests you, consider subscribing and turning the bell notification on as well. Also, consider giving the video a thumbs up. It really does help the channel out. And the Citi Double Cash is getting the ability to move your cash back to Citi thank you points. And I think this might actually be a game-changing move by Citi. Now, I've always felt the Citi Double Cash is the baseline for rewards earning, because earning 2% cash back, while it won't get you into first class seats, it was a great non-bonus credit card. Now the date I've seen fluctuates a little bit, but it's either gonna start September 21st or September 22nd, and you'll be able to move your cash back to Citi thank you points starting at $1, which will be 100 thank you points. So points are gonna be moved at a 1-to-1 ratio, which is great for a no fee credit card. And remember, you can transfer thank you points to any member, but when you transfer them, they expire 90 days after transferring. But this is great because you can pull points with other people, not only authorized users, which do give them advantage over the ultimate rewards or membership rewards. And while you can move your cash back to Citi thank you points, you're gonna get the best benefits when you have either the Prestige or the Premier credit card, because you're gonna unlock the ability to move these points to all of their airline partners. Plus, the Premier will let you redeem through the Citi travel portal at 1.25 cents per point, essentially making it 2.5% back when you redeem through their travel portal. And if you happen to only have the Citi Double Cash, you're only going to be able to transfer your points out to JetBlue at a 1,800 point ratio, which isn't good and it's also not bad, but if you really want to take full advantage of this, you need to have the Citi Premier or the Citi Prestige credit card. And Citi does have some really good airline partners, but they do take a little bit more work, but they are definitely worth the effort and learning. For example, I'm sure you've all heard about already using Turkish miles to fly to Hawaii for only 15,000 miles round trip in coach or 25,000 points round trip in business class, and this is a great value. But now that Citi is basically giving you the ability to redeem your rewards at 1 cent per point when you cash them out, or transfer your cash back over to Citi thank you points, it might actually make you want to take another look at this card if you don't already have it. Just because Citi's making these updates and it's a good credit card doesn't mean you should actually apply for it. And actually, I wouldn't apply for this card directly, and the reason for that is that there's no sign up bonus on the Citi Double Cash. But Citi allows you to product change from other family of cards. So what I would consider doing is getting a card like the American Airlines credit card for a bonus, and then I would product change that card to the Citi Double Cash. This way, you're getting a bonus, and then you can convert it to a card that gives you great ongoing benefits. Now, there are a few other things to consider now that this is happening with the Citi Double Cash. First, it now outshines the Chase Freedom Unlimited. By allowing the Double Cash to transfer cash back to thank you points, it now makes Chase the only big bank that doesn't have a card that offers 2x on flexible currency as an everyday card. American Express has the Blue Business Plus, and Citi now has the Double Cash to do that. The Chase Freedom Unlimited only earns at 1.5 points per dollar, and while the Double Cash can only transfer to JetBlue on its own, that's more than what the Chase Freedom Unlimited gives you. And by Citi doing this, this could potentially make Chase up their game here, which is a win for consumers. Next, let's talk about plastic. Now, if you've ever used plastic in the past, you know plastic is good for using for sign-up bonuses, but not much outside of that. But since these points can be transferred to partners, this could actually be worth the 2.5% fee to pay to use plastic. Because while there are certain restrictions with Visa or American Express in certain categories, MasterCard has fewer restrictions, at least for the time being. For example, you can't use an American Express or Visa to pay a mortgage, but you can with a MasterCard, and the Citi Double Cash is a MasterCard. For example, my mortgage is just about $2,000 per month, and by using my Citi Double Cash, I'll pay $600 in fees, but I'll have a total spend of $24,600 on my Citi Double Cash in a year's time. But by being able to move your rewards to thank you points, it makes plastic a better looking option outside of just meeting minimum spending requirements when you're using your Double Cash. Another benefit is that there's no limit on earnings. Before this change, the American Express Blue Business Plus was the best non-bonus card at 2 membership reward points per dollar, up to $50,000 in a calendar year. Now I know that's a business card and some people won't qualify or feel comfortable applying for business cards, but the Double Cash doesn't have any limits on earnings. So if you're someone who has a large spend, this could do better for you than the Blue Business Plus since there isn't a threshold on the points earnings. The fact that this potentially is uncapped is a great thing for large spenders. Next, let's talk about the MasterCard benefits. Because a few months back, we saw benefits roll out to World and World Elite MasterCards. And these include benefits like cell phone protection, Lyft credits, a Postmates credit, Box rewards, and Fandango credits as well. And the Citi Double Cash, well, it comes as a World or World Elite MasterCard. And these are pretty solid benefits to have. And they're even better on the fact that this is a no-fee credit card. And personally, I'm a big fan of cell phone protection coverage, and this card is a card I'm gonna be using to pay my cell phone bill over my Uber credit card. The fact that the Citi Double Cash will be able to move its rewards to thank you points, I think changes the non-bonus landscape and further solidifies the Double Cash's status as the baseline non-bonus credit card. Because this not only became a better non-bonus credit card than the Chase Freedom Limited and potentially the Blue Business Plus, but it might also make banks have to improve their products to compete with the Citi Double Cash. And really, if you're someone who already has the Citi Premier or the Prestige, then the Citi Double Cash definitely moved up your list as a non-bonus credit card. And I know I'm excited about this change, so my question for you is, what do you think of this change? Hey, if you like this video, consider giving it a thumbs up. And if you know somebody who might benefit from this video, feel free to share it with them. And if you want to help support the channel, a simple way is to use links on the website or in the description below. And if you like learning about credit cards, points, miles, cashback, or just flat out traveling for less, consider hitting the subscribe button down below. And until next time, safe travels, take care.